that he should never be allowed to walk the streets again.
Good evening. I want to talk to you this evening not as a psychiatrist, because I've never met you, and because probably a psychiatrist is the last kind of person you want to see. I do want to ask you to give yourself up. You see, you've made your point 8 times, and if you continue making your point, you're simply going to produce public sympathy for these prostitutes, and I'm sure that that is not what you want. I want to ask you for the supreme sacrifice. I want you to sacrifice your liberty for your beliefs. I want you to pick up the phone, not tomorrow, not next week, but now, and tell the police who you are.
Light district, he picked up his first prostitute, but he said, "I realized what a coarse and vulgar person the woman was, and my hatred for prostitutes grew."
For the past 4 years, 12 women have been horribly murdered and mutilated by a sick, sadistic maniac, the Yorkshire Ripper.
I would have never even guessed that he had a mental kink like that.
The Yorkshire Ripper has been silent for 14 months, the longest break in his catalogue of killings. Detectives and pathologists who'd worked on previous Ripper killings were certain she was his 13th victim.
But she's another victim of the so-called Ripper. This man will continue to kill until he's caught.
God, compassion, divine vengeance.
Peter!
his hands now. Good night, my love.
The police ought to be looking for, frankly, anybody.
The frenzied attack is carried out on these women. This man hates prostitution. She's had very severe head injuries. There are other injuries which I don't wish to elaborate on at this time.
Just shocking. For a young lass like that, she was beautiful.
It was a piece of routine police work by two officers that led to Sutcliffe's arrest in Sheffield last Friday night. A huge crowd had been gathering all day in the narrow streets outside Dewsbury's courthouse. As Sutcliffe arrived in a police van just before 5 o'clock, the crowd surged forward, shouting abuse and threats. Sutcliffe, covered by a blanket, was then rushed into the court building. The police were left struggling to hold back the crowds.
Just didn't expect it to be an ordinary, everyday sort of a chap, which he is.
For the first time since he pleaded guilty 2 weeks ago, the soft, slightly high-pitched Yorkshire voice of Sutcliffe rang out across the courtroom.
Terrible thing to think that he's been sat there, and all the time we've been warning the kids and one thing and another, and he's been sat over there laughing tin at us, hasn't he, really?
The jury watched fascinated as prosecuting counsel Mr. Harry Ognall held up a grisly collection of screwdrivers and hammers. There was even a hacksaw. This had been used in a vain attempt to cut the head off one of his victims.
In this truck.
He was a perfect employee. He was a good worker, a hard worker.
He's a man.
He was a very tidy worker.
Whose latent genius, if unleashed, would rock the nation. Whose dynamic energy would overpower those around him.
He was different. He was the odd man out.
Sutcliffe had talked again of his voices. As he did so, prison officers noticed that his eyes grew wider and wider. They seemed to gleam in a strange way. He also claimed that he'd heard an echoing voice in his cell saying, kill, kill.
Weather letting us down a bit. Who are you?
Very philosophical.
I'm Dr. Spencer.
I'm here to help you, Peter.
Spencer. Dr. Spencer.
I am a psychiatrist.
Angel. No room up in my cab. You'll have to try the next driver.
Very funny.
You're gonna need help. Adjusting in times of need. Peter, do you know what a psychiatrist is?
Well, the Greeks called us
healers of the soul.
I like that.
Psyche is the ethereal aspect of ourselves, apart. Distinct from our physical self.
You're odd. I weren't asked. I'm not happy.
Look, the people upstairs...
Aye, well, your problem. Not interested. I'm not being experimented on.
Peter, the truth is that they...
You're not sticking a load of drugs in me.
Who told you that? There are no drugs involved. You have my word.
What are you going to do to me?
Do to you? This is the 1980s. We talk through our troubles. You will be able to contact me when you are suffering in need. Hypnotherapy tends to be effective at these moments.
Hypnosis? No.
But you're searching out questions, looking for the answers. You can't do this alone. I mean, this treatment has been sanctioned by the highest authority.
Hypnosis?
They want to know why.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Why?
I shall not be again.
why you did those things.
I told them already. It were God. God told me to clean the streets of filth.
God?
Yes, God. I did what he or that voice told me to do.
God?
Yes, God.
Because you just said, or that voice.
It was God, because you know it's God talking to you when it's God talking to you. I don't like you. I want somebody else.
Look, I guarantee that these meetings, these sessions, will stay private and confidential. There is light at the end of every tunnel. Even yours. Work with me. Improve your chances so later on. Perhaps parole, Peter. I'm not at liberty to say any more right now.
That's rubbish. Every word. Something not quite right about you, Dr. Spencer. Oh, you're very nice. You're too nice.
The cold truth is, we both want, need results. The alternative is the people.
I know. You said all that already.
So? Agreed? Let's go on this journey together, Peter.
No. You talk, Dr. Spencer, but don't say a lot. Let's talk about you. About yourself. Tell me something.
Ah. Share secrets.
Aye. Because I'm...
Shh. Then sit and listen. I believe the child is the father of the man. But there's a time to every purpose. Time in our childhood. A dark time. A time of sadness. Then. Seven. Six.
Don't listen.
Five. Four. Three. Two.
Stay awake.
One.
You could walk past the school yard during the play period in the afternoon. Then he'd be stood in a corner by himself.
Sutcliffe said that his mission to kill began here, Bingley Cemetery, where, as a teenager, he worked as a gravedigger. Something happened
that I thought was wonderful, Sonia. I believed it then and now. That it was the voice of God. I was standing over an open grave, you know, taking a rest from digging. I heard a voice. Yeah, that's it. It was a Polske.
He was only a small baby, he only weighed 5 pounds when he was born. It took a long while to grow up. Catch up with other children.
Here are 2 children, rather bigger, but otherwise still pretty much the same. They're just on the point of growing up. Take first the boy. He'll find his voice growing gruff and manly, and hair beginning to grow on his face. Hair will appear around his sex organs too, and these will be bigger, becoming ready to fulfill the new and important tasks assigned to them. She's growing up too. Like the male, she too will grow hair around her sexual parts, and she'll find that a well-developed bosom becomes part of her charms. Of course, that's not all the breasts are for. They're there to provide her babies with the perfect baby food when the time comes. Later. Girlfriend.
And it was around this time that the friends he drank with in pubs in the area began to notice that he had difficulty forming relationships with women.
The time I knew Peter for that roughly 2 year period, he never had a girlfriend.
He never had a girlfriend?
No, no.
Why was that?
He didn't seem to take off. His conversation, you know, at that time, he was a good-looking lad, there was no doubt about it, you know, in his own way, but his conversation wasn't really too good, you know, not much chat.
He used to ask me to, you know, if I had a mate that had make up a foursome, but none of my mates were ever interested, you know.
They didn't fancy
him? They didn't know. Not the local girls, you know. They were just quiet, deep.
An ex-gravedigger tells the story of how Sutcliffe had once shown him a handful of rings.
There'd be about 5 or 7 rings, you know. And he said, I've got these, you know, body, you know, off at bodies, like, you know.
Just want a word with my Julie.
I got no brass till Monday.
Oh, Gary.
Oh, Gary.
I'm a healer of souls.
So, you new around here?
Looking for work. Do you know where's hiring?
A couple of strong lads like you. You'll have no trouble finding it.
And willing?
I've no doubt. I've no doubt you're willing. My sister, she had the nouse to go and work down south.
Says you get a some entertainment.
People, you know, cosmopolitan.
Are you watching Dr. Spencer?
Sophisticated. Not like fuck me.
Did he have any girlfriends?
Not really. The first one that I knew of was the girl he married, Sonia. Still at school. Beautiful girl, only 16 years of age when he met her.
Welcome back. With me is Suzanne Chapman. Welcome, Susanna.
Looking lovely as ever.
Hello, Jack. Thank you for inviting me on your show.
This is the fourth murder now in 3 years, two within weeks of each other. What do your sources tell you?
Well, my source is
concerned. Something happened that I thought was wonderful, Sonia. I believed it then and now. That it was the voice of God. I heard a voice.
So what's it like being married? Nice. That's nice. Kids?
Aye. Probably. Soon. Got a house. Home of our own. Nice garden and all. She's gone and stuck a couple of school desks upstairs. We should educate the kids at home, Peter.
Are you kidding? Women are mad.
Aye. Her mother's a slag as well. Mother and daughter. A right pair of dogs. They, you know, get down to it. Together, like.
Together?
Not a pretty picture. A right pair of mucky bitches. So ugly. They have to do tricks. Together, you know, for cash. To keep warm.
I heard they say, the really dirty ones, they wear those, you know, French knickers.
Aye. Filthy. Disgusting. Believe me, punters go through them all night. Like the return style.
A turnstile? That's funny.
You're right. It is funny. Like a turnstile. Click, 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 dick. Click, 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 dick.
Dick. Click, 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 dick.
Now, a lot of girls who are walking in the streets of Leeds in the night time, whether they're in groups or singly, are carrying small pocket alarms rather like this one. Now, the alarms that are on the market often make a different tone, but apparently this particular model is very popular in this part of the country. Now, it makes a very distinctive sound, and I've been asked by the nurses in Leeds to demonstrate it for Canada, so that if you hear this noise, then you'll know what it is. It's a cry for help, and this is what it sounds like.
I also have information from a person who says that they believe they saw Helen get into a white car at the end of Great Northern Street near the junction with Millhouse Lane. I wanted anybody that was in that area during that vital 15 minutes to come forward.
God told me to clean the streets of mud.
What's that for?
It's a briefcase, sir. Oh,
thanks, Lammy, you spanner. What the hell are you carrying that thing around for?
It's for me notes, sir.
Notes? Notes? Up here, lad. My notes are up here. What happens when you lose that thing? Your poor mam's gonna have to go out and buy her another one. How old did you say she were?
18, sir, we think.
Dear Lord. Who's coming, Mum, Dad?
Neither, sir. She's a... was an orphan.
So?
My sister, sir.
No. Who else?
Nobody. I can call the office.
Three sugars, stirred once.
Just perfect. Thank you.
Off you go.
Gentlemen, there's somebody here waiting to see us.
Back now.
tidy, precise, but who at times can, to coin a phrase, flip his lid?
Would remorse play any part in his makeup?
None at all. In view of the fact that he's still doing these offences, even though he knows there's a massive police search and still getting away with it, I would rate this fellow's intelligence very high.
Is there any significance in the fact that he does not appear to try to hide the bodies?
Significant in terms of him being a psychopath, that's all. He doesn't care. When he's done it, that's it.
Picked a nice weekend for it. My name's Mike, and you're early.
Well, Mike, we're not. I telephoned your boss, Mr. Baxter.
Aye. He told me what you needed. She's been made ready.
Well, it's rude to keep a lady waiting. Shall we proceed?
All right, yeah. Funny. So this way, please. Mind your step.
Strong suspicion that his name is Mike and that he's a nosy bastard.
Oh, yeah, funny.
Will McKeown's body was found battered and mutilated here exactly 4 years ago. That something had sparked off the killer instinct in the mind of a man who'd become known as the Yorkshire Ripper. The way he killed Wilma McKeown was so distinctive that it's become his trademark, and the police have been very careful not to release details for fear of carbon copy killers.
Professor David G, who carried out the post-mortem, said she had severe head injuries and multiple injuries to her trunk.
She had very severe head injuries. There are other injuries which I don't wish to elaborate on at this time. Attack, transit attack is carried out on these women. Indicates that an aggressive...
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch a nigger by the toe. Left-handed. Agreed?
They've revealed few details as to the Ripper's exact methods. However, it is known that a ball-peen hammer, similar to this one, has been used in the initial attack in most of the killings. This morning, Nicholas, he's been in a state of complete collapse. I think this has been added to him.
Are you ready with that thing?
I look at them with pity and hate.
Have you finished with her already?
Peter, finished already? It's not a race. You don't win a prize.
Sorry, but I want to be ready. Dr. Spencer's coming.
Spencer? Aye. Up at Broadmoor, they all thought they were special. But I couldn't tell the difference. Who shrinks were from nutters.
The hospital? You moving to the Broadmoor?
Just a glimmer on my horizon. A change of pace would be welcome. None of us are getting any younger. And that includes you. You've got gravy on your chin. So, tell me. What do you and Dr. Special talk about all day?
I'm not at liberty to say. Sorry, Alec, but it's private. Confidential. I thought you were told.
P's and C's. Bollocks.
Peter, did you know that I'm special? Aye. Surprised? Peter, I've secret powers. Powers of telepathy.
Go on. Laugh. But it's true. Want me to prove it?
Please stop. Please stop making that sound.
Hang on. It's faint. He's promised you if you cooperate, that is. My God. Parole.
Well, he told me.
Peter, he's a fake. And you're lying to yourself. Get a grip, man. Can Spencer fly an helicopter? Throw a rope down, will he? Face facts. You're going nowhere, laddie. So forget about Broadmoor. And forget about parole. You sure he's coming in today?
He should be here already.
Well, I've got me rounds. But I will pop back later. Introduce myself. Say hello. Okay.
Okay.
Alex is a fool, but he has a point.
What are you saying? I have a right to know.
Mad bastard. So, what do you want to know?
I don't know. You want to hypnotize me, get in my head. But why should I? But what about you? How long have you been a psychiatrist? Are you married? Did you always want to be a doctor? Paint me a picture.
Sorry, but you're right. I did dream of being an artist, famous artist.
Do you like Francis Bacon?
However, life turned out conventional, much like yours before. And yes, I'm married. Nice house. I like woodwork. Nothing fancy.
Small desk. Coffee table.
Kids.
Children. No, Peter. That's something that I... just never happened. Now it...
Prostitutes.
Sorry. Beg your pardon?
Prostitutes? Slags? You know. Have you been with any prozzies?
Well...
Aye. You randy old bugger. How many? Go on, tell us. Didn't like that, did you? Doctor Special. But you like control. You like hypnosis. Like to rummage around in here just so you can get famous. Perot. Laughing behind me back. Judging me. While you're shagging prozzies behind your wife's back. Aye. Woodwork.
But Peter. It's not me. It's you. It's about the things you did. About why you did them. Because you're trapped in here. Not me. You chose the tools. You built that cross. Not me. To every purpose. Time of truth. Time you buried your guilt. Time to dig up the guilt which you buried. 10, 9, 8, 7. Six, five, four, three, two, one.
Someone's praying, my Lord, come by us.
Even when we had children later, he was still the one that was hanging onto Mother's apron strings all the time. He rather shunned the company of other boys because they were always seemed to be much too big for him.
I don't believe in racialism or religion. I believe that all the Catholics and Jews and Protestants and Methodists should all get together and attack the Pakistan.
So in 5 years of looking for him, what picture have they now built up of Britain's most wanted man?
It's agreed that his height is around 5'8". He has a strong Wearside accent and is probably in his early 30s. Footprints show that he wears size 7 Wellington boots.
He's a nigger. Simple as that.
Well, how do you know?
Facts. Hair. Fuzzy. Like a pussy. Right? Now, showed that sight lad a clean pair of heels. And that coloured prosy up in Chapel Town. The one that got bumped on the head. Well, she said he was a smooth talker. Facts.
It was teeth marks left on her body that gave police the valuable information that the killer had a gap between two of his upper teeth.
Now, with the impetus of new leadership, the Ripper Squad say morale is high. The teams of detectives checking on possible suspects say they've got all the information, a pen picture of the man they want.
One of Pakistani, then?
Pakis can't run. Fact. Pakis can't chat up birds. Fact. You ask my sister. She caught one and married him.
There's a very strong feeling that tomorrow, this afternoon, 5 minutes after we leave you, we might be knocking on the right door and have the right man.
Sometimes we feel her around us. The smell of her hair on our pillows and...
Dear Sonia.
The laughter of her voice in another room.
I'm having terrible dreams lately.
That's all we
voices
have.
In my head.
They should lock you up.
Voices.
Never.
In this dream, telling me to write this letter.
Every one of these women who've been murdered is somebody's daughter. And some of them had young children.
I killed all those women.
She'll be as sick as the rest of us when she finds out.
Sonia, I'm the Ripper.
You're inadequate, what it must be. That's why you do these things.
If the man who's done these things is
you
watching...
You did to her.
Then I beg you to give yourself up. You need a doctor's help. Give yourself
up. Pick up the phone and hand yourself in.
I want to appeal to you to come forward and give yourself up before you take any more girls' lives. I mean, we may be prostitutes, but we still have a life.
To her body. She must have begged you.
I'm so
to
sorry
stop.
That I lied to you. Oh, Father, why are you doing?
Can you imagine what it's like to have your heart ripped out?
I can't stop thinking.
That's what you did to me.
Thinking of a way to stop. But if I'm honest, Sonia, I don't want to stop.
I saw what you did to her.
Did you die?
You
bastard.
Find this letter, please. Don't keep it.
What about your soul?
Please read it and throw it away.
Who is going to save me? God shows compassion and love. What do you know about it? You took my girl's life and broke her father's heart. Mine as well.
We are getting nearer and nearer to you every minute. And it's only a matter of time before your call.
Can't even tell people what you did. It's shocking.
What right have these people to judge me? What do they know?
All they do is drink, take drugs, and spread the filthy diseases. Men are no better.
What is the interest to Japanese people of a story like this?
I think why this sort of awful affairs happen in this peaceful country.
Japanese! They're everywhere, out there, trying to talk to people.
What the hell are you blethering on about, Jan?
That's what I'm telling you. They've come here especially to try and, you know, to communicate with us. They're asking about the Yorkshire Ripper.
What is the Japanese image of Britain, then?
I think Britain, even though there is a strike, but the landscape is very beautiful and the people's mind is very nice.
Oh, thanks, Flower.
Oh, no. It won't do. I'll have to go to Lavi and make room for it.
Very charming.
Hey, Paul. I've got garden furniture smarter than that one.
Oi, cut it out.
Weak. Going with these sad old women. Selling the bodies in pubs for a few free jars and a lift home.
Don't you have sex with a woman?
There's no morality anymore.
Is that it?
If there were, there'd be more people like me.
No one wants you.
You don't love me!
Shut up, you're drunk. Jan! Jan! Don't keep throwing those things down the toilet. They never flush.
Oh, sorry, Flower. Won't happen again, I promise. Oh, hey. I love this one.
I bear this cross. I bear it alone. I've been asked. I have been.
We want to know.
So I think we have, and this country has a lot of culture and tradition. So in the world, I think the peaceful and loving country.
We're there! Everyone knows she's just an old flag!
So to Japanese people, this story is something different about Britain?
Yes, I think they are a little bit surprised.
Peter.
I look at them with pity and hate.
God asked you, Peter Sutcliffe?
Peter.
Dr. Spencer. The darkness around me is nothing.
We're going to get you.
Compared to the darkness within people. I can shut out the darkness around me.
We're going to get you, Peter.
But there's no switch. The darkness inside people. Light!
Oh, Peter.
Oh, Doctor. Come closer now and see your dreams. Come closer and see mine.
Peter Sutcliffe arrived at Newport Crown Court amid the strictest security. He'd been brought from the island's Parkhurst prison, where he's serving a life sentence for 13 murders. Costello claimed they'd been arguing about a prison newspaper. Sutcliffe said it was The Sun, one of the worst papers, he said, and he admitted that he'd been in the habit of blacking out and altering articles in the paper that dealt with prostitution and vice. But he firmly denied attacking Costello. I'm talking facts, said Sutcliffe. You're telling lie after lie after lie. You need all the help you can get, not from this court, but from a psychiatrist. After much of this kind of dialogue, Costello's cross-examination of his fellow prisoner was still not finished when the court rose. It'll continue tomorrow. He was cheered by a small crowd waiting outside as he left.
Following the attack on him in 1983, it was decided to move Peter Sutcliffe from Parkhurst on the Isle of Wight to Broadmoor Hospital for the Criminally Insane. Sutcliffe has a certain celebrity status, receiving dozens of fan letters and requests from the media, but so far has refused interviews.
Sonia says you're not real. You're just a voice in my head. Alec's real.
Peter.
You're just a voice in my head. Dr. Spencer says you're a voice in...
Thanks for seeing me, Peter.
Dr. Spencer has always been against the idea.
But I thought that was Parker's. Spencer? Yes, well. And he's continued his work here.
Aye. Sonia says you're not real.
Final saying matters.
Made Alec's it clear real. To him that we should you're just a voice in my head. Like. Sonia
if
says
Spencer,
you're all just voices in my head. You're just
you
a voice in my
Peter.
Head.
These paintings, I find them very interesting.
Lots of people say that, that they find something very interesting in them.
Well, I've got some questions prepared.
Sonia warned me I'd have people. Loads of people coming in here with the loaded questions.
You need a turnstile, not a door, Peter.
Dr. Spencer reckons I should replace my door with a turnstile.
Turnstile?
Yeah. Click, 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 click.
I must say that myself and my family, our hearts go out to the relatives of those girls, whoever they are, wherever they are. It's absolutely horrifying to me. Not that it should just be my son, but that it should be Peter. I would have never...
Mummy, you're evil.
...even guessed that he had a mental kink like that which caused him to do these sort of things. If I had, there is no doubt about it that I would have turned him in. This thing had to stop. It was getting out of hand.
I'll protect you from the hooded claw. Keep the vampires from your door.
Feels like fire. I'm so in love with you. Dreams are like angels, they keep bad at bay, bad at bay. Love is the light, scaring darkness away, yeah. I'm so in love with you, purge the soul. Make love your goal. The power of love, a force from above, cleaning my soul. Flame on, burn desire, love with tongues of fire.
Good. And God, just take away and all. Evil and devil. Just add a D, Doctor. At 4 in the morning, the devil is God. But he's driving home in the opposite direction.
Your physician. Can I?
Wait. Please, listen. And God going home the other way is... Dog. Yes. Correct. You see? A prosy ride is just a dog. But only she's actually God. I'm a healer of souls.
Elvis!
Congratulations, Peter. Because in the whole world, God... God asked you, Peter Sutcliffe. Never asked me. Why not Jimmy? Why?
I don't know.
Why not 12? 11? 10? 9?
Four. last night that he was put aboard an ambulance and driven under police escort from Frimley Park, where he'd been treated for eye injuries. Peter Sutcliffe was said to be recovering in a medical wing at the top security hospital.
Dr. Spencer, is that you?
Yes, Peter. It's me.
Is Dr. Spencer real?
No. Is Peter blind?
They're saying I'm blind.
Your faith is your strength because... Well, because, Peter, there's been a lot of damage.
I want to pray. Will you pray with me, Doctor?
Of course I will, Peter.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not be in want. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul.
Even as I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall feel no evil.
My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell
in the house of the Lord forever. Forever. Remember. Remember.
He restores my soul. Even as I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff. Even as I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall see the evil. For you are with me. For you are with me. Even as I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For you are with me. For you are with me. Even as I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. No evil.
Children have grown-up bodies. But what about their minds?
In the killing years, Peter Sutcliffe terrorised the north of England, and with every murder, fears increased that he would kill again. So it's hardly surprising that in a regional television poll which asked the question this afternoon, should he have been allowed out on compassionate grounds, 91% of people said no.
The van left the secure hospital at 5:30 a.m. to begin the 540-mile round trip to Arnside in Cumbria. At 10 o'clock, he reached the site where his father's ashes were scattered 7 months ago.
Thank you.
Shouldn't we get closer?
Look at him. Give it another 5 minutes, then we'll get him back in van.
It's not right, you know. I don't like it. Not one bit.
Shut up and keep focused. Last thing we need is a group of vigilantes. Let him mourn.
His father died ages ago. Why now? It just doesn't make sense to me.
We're not paid to think. Let him do what he needs to do. Then we'll stick him back in van and go get us breakfast.
Dr. Spencer, I'm not the suicide type.
Guilt. Compassion.
He was my son. He's still my son. As long as I'm alive, he'll still be my son. I'm not trying to forgive him for what he's done.
Beautiful, isn't it?
I'm just hoping that someday, somebody will fathom his mind. And whoever that someone may be, I hope they'll give us a logical explanation of what happened. In the meantime, as far as I'm concerned, it could have been anyone's son. It just happens to be mine.
It's like a dream, really, but it's all real.
Hey, turn it up. Peter, tell us, have you heard this one? Do you remember it? Come on, you mad old bastard. Let's be having you. You have to exercise, Peter.
25.
Get some air into your lungs.
Twenty-six. 27.
Dr. Spencer.
And day before that?
Steak, I think.
Timo, what did Yorkie have for lunch today?
Not sure, he's snacking all the time, so has lunch later. Probably about now.
7.
Let me go and check.
8, 9, 10.
That's all he eats. He's gonna balloon like a big, big,
balloon? Stop doing that and listen. That fat bastard's gonna have an heart attack.
Yeah, I know.
You don't? No, nothing. Because you've been here 5 minutes, and I've known him for years. We had a tranny, but no fanny. Try a Susie side. Press had a pick. Nick, it was a circus. Upstairs held an inquiry. It took months. And you and him and me can forget about our Ollie days.
I'm sorry, Ollie.
He likes you. Have a chat. Talk to him. Make him cooperate.
How? Like what, Alec?
I don't know. Summon. Bribe him with...
Steak. Jeff's got his tray ready.
Good evening, one of Britain's most notorious murderers who took the lives of 13 women during his reign of terror thought he may one day walk free. Today, a judge told Peter Sutcliffe in no uncertain terms that will never happen and he will die in jail.
He started killing prostitutes, but his victims would include students and a Sunday school teacher. 13 women died, others survived with terrible injuries. Today, their families expressed relief that he'll never be free. Dismissing the case for release, Mr. Justice Mitting said, apart from a terrorist outrage, it is difficult to conceive of circumstances in which one man could account for so many victims. Those circumstances alone make it appropriate to set a whole life term.
Fresh air and exercise. I hear you've been getting lots, Peter.
Well, I'm being made ready. I've got to be ready. Be prepared.
For what? You're trying again. Next year.
Nothing's confirmed. I would like you there, standing next to me.
Shoulder to shoulder.
Brothers in arms.
Well, Pete, if they choose to contact me, if they... people upstairs ask me my considered opinion. I will give it.
And you should, Dr. Spencer.
And I will, Peter. If they call me. These people are... How should I couch this? Sometimes a mystery to me. Frankly, it's easier trying to fathom the mind of patients.
So?
Peter, I have to maintain impartiality. But yes, I agree. You have a peace. An inner peace. Perhaps a perfect peace.
Thank you, Doctor. You know, over the years I...
No. There's no need for that, Peter. Because, yes, it's my professional opinion that you are ready for society. But, Peter, is society ready for you?
Dr. Spencer, I don't understand. I thought you were my friend. I thought that we had an understanding.
Oi, stop mucking about and get in. It's too bloody cold.
Just a minute.
Nor a minute. Nor a second. But now.
Peter, do as he asks. It is cold. We can talk later.
Peter!
Goodbye, Peter.
I know you're not there, but I want you to be there.
Make love your
between you and I. I don't know where I stand, faced with a cruel world. I'd say everything points to the disappearance of the girl. Economy of blessings. Ooh,
You.